वंदेहं
The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 15th chapter, text number 1, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 28th of October, 1973, in Bombay, India.
Sri Rupam Chakrajatam
There is a banyan tree which has its roots upward and its branches down, and whose leaves are the Vedic hymns. One who knows this tree is the knower of the Vedas.
So, this is the description of Vedic literature. Vedishta sarvai aham eva vedyam. That is the describe. Veda means knowledge. Vetti Veda Vida Jnane Vidh Dhatu From Vidh Dhatu the word Veda has come. It means knowledge. There are different kinds of knowledge and all kinds of knowledge you can get perfectly from the Vedas. There is Dhanud Veda, Ayur Veda, Rig Veda, Sham Veda, different branches of Veda. But the objective of studying Vedas means to understand Krishna. Veda is the sarvai, all kinds of Vedas. Any book of knowledge. There are different types of book of knowledge. So, if by studying the books of different types of knowledge, one comes to the understanding of knowing the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, then his knowledge is perfect. Therefore, Krishna says, Bahunam Janmanam Ante. After studying Vedas, speculative knowledge, bhavanam janmanavante jnanavan, when one is actually a wise man, bhavanam janmanavante jnanavan mang prapadvati, he surrenders to Krishna. Why? Vasudeva sarvamiti, because Krishna is everything. Parasa Brahmana Shakti, whatever we see, whatever we experience, that is everything Krishna's energy. This material world is also expansion of Krishna's energy. Similarly, the spiritual world is also expansion of Krishna's energy, the Brahma Jyoti, is also expansion of Krishna's energy. Paramatma is also expansion of Krishna's plenary portion. In this way, when one understands perfectly well that whatever we are experiencing, that is Krishna's energy. It is described in the Vishnu Purana. Eka deshe sthita shagne Jyotsna vistarina jatha parasya brahmana shakti sarvedam akhilam jagat. This jagat, akhil jagat, is nothing but manifestation of Krishna's energy, parasya brahmana shakti. Parabrahma is Krishna. We may be Brahma because we are part and parcel of Krishna. Therefore, we are Brahma. Now we are identifying with this matter. So, mukti means when we stop identifying with this matter, and we learn how to realize Aham Brahmasmi. Simply realization, not to act as Brahma. That is perfection of knowledge. Not to simply realize. Just like, for example, a person, he feels that I am Indian. That is very good. But Mahatma Gandhi, he also was Indian, but he acted as a first-class Indian. Therefore Mahatma Gandhi is so much adored. So simply to realize that I am Brahma, Aham Brahmasmi, that is not perfection. That is avishuddha buddha, unclean intelligence, jinnir vindyakha vimukta manina, tai astabhavat avishuddha buddha. Simply understanding aham brahmasmi will not help us, because it is stated in the shastra that arujya krichena param padam tatha patanti adha. Even by severe austerities and penances, one comes to the stage of merging into Brahma, sadhujya mukti. Still, there is chance of falling down. Arujya krichena param padam tatha patanti adha. Why? Now, anadita jusmat angraya. One who has not realized the lotus feet of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, he falls down. We have seen many big sannyasi in India, very learned scholar, and very nicely they can describe shastra also. But they are entangled in politics. Why? If this world is mithya, jagat mithya, you have rejected it, then why you are again coming to politics? Why you are coming in the mithya world? Because there is no realization. Avishuddha buddha, jinnir vindyakha vimukta manina. They are thinking that we have now become liberated. Manina. Actually, they are not liberated, because avishuddha buddha, their intelligence is not yet clear. Therefore, even after severe austerities, penances, they come to the point of Brahma realization. Because they have no realization of the lotus feet of Krishna, they fall down. Because there is no engagement. I do not wish to name the big sannyasis of India who fell down in this way. But you know that the Mayavadi sampradaya, they take this world as mithya, Brahma Satya Jagat mithya. If jagat is mithya, then why you come down again for philanthropy activities, for political activities? That is called Maya. That is the last snare of Maya. Maya dictates that now you have failed to become minister, to president, and so many other big posts. Now you become Brahma. Then you are already Brahma. Simply you have to realize. That's all. That is knowledge. That I am not the Brahma realization means that I am not this body. Because so long one identifies with this body, he is no better than anyone. That is the first lesson Krishna says in the beginning of the Bhagavad Gita. Dehinasmin jatha dehi kaumano jauvanang jala tatha dehantara prati dehi and dehina. So, that is preliminary knowledge of Brahma realization. But if you do not fix up in your Brahma realization, That is Parabhakti. Brahma Bhutam. Prasannatma nasochati nakankati samas sarveshu bhuteshu madbhakti labhate param. When actually one is liberated from the bodily concept of life and he sees spiritual identity everywhere, samas sarveshu bhuteshu, pandita samadarshana, then he can be situated in the activities of Brahma. The bhakti yoga is the activities of Brahma. The Mayavadi philosophers, they think that after Brahma realization, there is no more activity. But that is not the fact. Real activity begins after Brahma realization. That is Brahma activity. That is bhakti yoga. Krishna is Param Brahma, and we are Krishna's part and parcel. Naturally, we are also Brahma, because part and parcel of gold must be gold. There is no doubt about it. But it does not mean that the small particle of gold is equal to the gold mine. That is not possible. Part is never equal to the whole. So Krishna has already described bhakti yoga. Now he is describing about the activities of this material world. Trigunna Vishaya, material world, activities of the material world means to act in such a way that you become liberated at the end and go back to home, back to body. That is real activities of this material world. Not to act as the animals, eating, sleeping, mating. So this material world is now described compared with a banyan tree which has its root upwards, above. That means this material world is created from the spiritual world. Eko Narayana, in the spiritual world, there is always Narayana. Even Shankaracharya, he says, Narayana abhaktyat param. The spiritual world has nothing to do with this material world. This material world is created. Just like the banyan tree, it takes its root and it is created. So, the seed of the creation is in the spiritual world. Sa ikkhata, sa asyajata. The creation is coming from the spiritual world. Spiritual world means the kingdom of God, Narayana or Krishna. So, here the spiritual material world is described as urdhva moolam. In other words, it is reflection of the spiritual world. Just like if you stand on the shore of a lake, you'll find all the trees reflected in the water downwards. Reality is on the shore of the lake and the reflection is downwards. The upper part of the tree has gone down. So this material world is compared with that reflection. It is chaya. In Brahma Sangita also it is Sishti-sthiti pralaya sadhana saktirika chayeva jasya bhuvanani vibhati durga. The superintending deity of this material world is Goddess Durga, Durga Shakti. So she creates this material world, Sishti-sthiti pralaya sadhana saktirika, Krishna's energy. Krishna also says in the Bhagavad Gita, Bhumi Rapo Nalo Vayu, this material energy is his energy. The energy is always compared with feminine part. And the energetic is always compared with the male part and female part. Krishna also said in the Bhagavad Gita, Aham Bija Pada Pita. So he is the seed giving father. Bijoham Sarva Bhutana. So he is the original seed of this material world. And from there, from the spiritual world, it has expanded. Urdhamala Adhashvaka. Asatyam Prahu Abhayam. Abhayam Eternal. This material energy also eternal. There are three kinds of energies of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. The material energy, the spiritual energy, and the marginal energy. From the material energy, Bhumi Rapa Analabhai, this material creation is affected. And the spiritual energy, the Vaikuntha Loka, Parastasmatu Bhava Anya, Bhaktya Bhaktya Sanatana, that is eternal. So that is spiritual world. And in between the two worlds, material and spiritual, there is one energy, that is living energy, we, living entities. We are marginal energy. We are also energy. Aparayam itastu vidhi me prakitim para, jiva bhuta mahabhava, jayidam dharjate jagat. Krishna describes the marginal energy, the jiva-bhūta, the living entities. So, jiva-bhūta, living entities, they are actually prakriti, not purusha. Purusha is supreme personality of God. Purusha means enjoy. But Mayavadi philosophy, they want to turn the prakriti into purusha. The jiva, jiva is described as prakriti, para-prakriti, jiva-bhūta. They are better than, superior than the matter, because they adjust matter, the resources, the material resources. They try to enjoy it. They cannot enjoy, but try to enjoy it. Therefore it is called superior energy. But it is energy, not the energetic. So this material world is eternal. And the living entities, they are also eternal, abhaya, nahannati hannamane sarire. And eternal, this material world is eternal in this sense, because it is Krishna's energy. If Krishna is eternal, his energy is also eternal. But the manifestation of this energy is temporary. Bhutta bhutta praliyate. Energy is there. Unless the energy is there, how it is manifested? Janmadrasya jata. There are so many energies within you, within me. They are not always manifest. But at times they are manifest. They are called achinta shakti. Things are happening without our calculation. That is achinta shakti, inconceivable energy. As Krishna has got inconceivable energy, he creates this material world by his inconceivable energy, vast oceans, vast lump of matter, the universe. Jasyaika nishasita kalama thavalamba jivanti loma vilaja jagadanna natha. Vishnu mahan sahiya jasya kalavishisa govinda madhipurisam tamaham bhajan. So, Mahavishnu, by his breathing only, unlimited number of universes are coming and going into. So such inconceivable energies are there. And because we are part and parcel of Krishna, we have got also inconceivable energy, which is not always manifest, but at times it manifests. Similarly, this material world is abhaya, eternal energy, but it is not false, as the Mayavadi philosophers say, jagat mithya. No, jagat is not mithya, but it is fact, but it is temporary. That is Vaishnava philosophy. We don't say that this world is false. Why it should be false? If it has come from the truth, absolute truth, How it can be? Purnamidam, Purnamada, Purnamidam, Purnat, Purnamidachati. It is perfect, but it is being misused. That is Maya. How it is being misused? The Krishna says that He is the enjoyer. Bhoktaram Jagratam Sam, Sarvaloka Maheshwaram. He is the proprietor of all the lokas, all the brahmandas. But unfortunately, we are dismissing Krishna. We are trying to be the enjoyer of this material. That is Maya. The world is not Maya, but the intention of the living entities to enjoy this material world, to satisfy his senses, that is Maya. He is becoming entangled. Just to try to enjoy this material world, that the so-called scientists and philanthropists and politicians, they are trying to enjoy this material world to their best capacity, and they are inventing devices how to enjoy it. This is Maya. That is answered in the Bhagavad Gita. Daivinchesa-gunamayi-mama-maya-durattaya. They are allured by this Maya, try to enjoy me. And these conditioned souls are after them. How to enjoy? Taigunna-visaya-vedana-staigunna-bhavali. Vedas also says that if you make such and such sacrifice, then you will be elevated to such and such higher planetary system to become demigods and enjoy beautiful women, higher standard of life. So, jāmimāṁ puṣpitāṁ vācha, vedu-vādu-ratā-prātha, nannada-sthiti-vādu. So, we must understand what is this material world, how it is working. That will be described in this 15th chapter. Urtha-mūna-madhas-śākam, asattam-prāhu-rabhyam, chandyāṁ-sijasya-parnāni, jastaṁ-veda-saveda-vi. One who understands what is the constitution of this material world, how it is working, what we are, why you have come here, why you are so struggling hard for existence, what is our duty, how to get out of this entanglement, that is Vedic knowledge. Not only to get out of this material entanglement, but to be engaged, because simply to get out is not the final business. Suppose you are being employed in a place you do not like, you want to change it. Simply if you resign your post, that is not good. You must take another nice post, then it is good. Anyone who is engaged in the eternal service of the Lord, he is perfect, he is mukta. Mukti hitvas annatha rupam sarupena avastiti. This is mukti. Mukti means to be free from the useless activities. The material activities, they are all useless activities, because in the bodily concept of life, just like the monkey, he is also very active. In Vrindavan you have got good experience, always active, but useless. Therefore, Srila Rupa Goswami has described Phalgu Vairagya. The monkey is Vairagya. He lives in the forest. He has no cloth in. Other Vairagyas, they have got little cloth, but these monkeys have no cloth. And they live in forest and eat fruits, vegetarian. But rascal number one. So, therefore Rupa Goswami has said, prapanchikataya buddhya parisambandhi vastuna mumukshubi parityaga phalgu vairagakata. Phalgu means less value, less important. Or there is Phalgu River. Phalgu River, you know, in Gaya, there is a Phalgu River. On the bed of the river you will find all sand, dry. But if you push your hand little below the sand, you will find water. This is practice, therefore it is called Phalgu Vairagya. Actually, outside as vairagi, no cloth, does not touch even cloth. But inside, every monkey has one dozen wife at least. So this kind of phalgu vairagi or morkot vairagi is not required. Sri Rupa Goswami says, prapanchikataya buddhya hari sambandhi vastuna mumukshu viparityaga phalgu vairaga katta. Vairagya actually, we cannot make actually vairagyam. Vairagyam means to refrain from material enjoyment or sense enjoyment. That is vairagya. Vasudevi bhagavati bhakti yogam prayojita janayati asu vairagya. Janayati asu vairagya jnananta jada haitakam. Jnana and vairagya, these two things are required. Purify our existence. And that is made possible simply by devotional service to Lord Vasudeva Krishna. Vasudevi bhagavati bhakti yoga prayojita janayati asu vairagya. Very soon one becomes vairagya. Just like this European American boy, they are vairagyas. They were engaged in full material enjoyment, but they have given up for Krishna's sake, everything. No illicit sex life, no intoxication, no meat eating, and no gambling. They have given up. This is vairagya. But the energy is utilized for Krishna's service. They are preaching this Krishna consciousness movement all over the world. It was the duty of the Indians. Unfortunately, the Indians are callous. They are now after technology. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu advised all Indians, Bharat bhumite manushya janma haila ja, janma sarthak kari karo paropakar. The paropakar to distribute Krishna consciousness. Everybody is suffering for want of God consciousness or Krishna consciousness. Therefore, it is the greatest humanitarian work, welfare activities, is to distribute this Krishna consciousness. So it was the duty of the Indians. Bharat bhumite manushya janma hailaja. Anyone who has taken birth as a human being in India, his duty is to perfect his life by becoming Krishna conscious and distribute it all over the world. That is his duty. But they are not doing. Somewhere or other, I have collected some of these young Europeans and Americans. They are helping in this movement. So, we have come to Vrindavan for this purpose, that those who are actually serious to render service to Krishna, they should join this movement heart and soul and help broadcasting this movement all over the world. Thank you very much.